Good day, everyone. Welcome to the world of math. Halikayo, samahan niyo ako para tuklasin ang mga bagong kaalaman sa mundo ng matematika.
Graphing quadratic functions. Let me present to you the competencies. Locate and plot points on the Cartesian plane. Graph a quadratic function. Domain, range, intercept, axis of symmetry, vertex, direction of the opening of the parabola, and analyzes the effects of changing the values of a, h, and k in the equation y is equal to a times the square of x minus h plus k of a quadratic function in its graph. Analyze the effects of changing the values of a, h, and k in the equation y is equal to a times the square of x minus h plus k of the quadratic function on its graph. What to know? Always remember that a quadratic function is a function that can be written in the form f of x is equal to ax squared plus bx plus c. For real numbers a, b, and c, with a must not equal to 0. So always remember that f of x is also y. The graph of every quadratic function is a parabola. So always remember the vertex is the lowest point of the parabola that opens upward, or the highest point on the parabola that opens downward. The vertex of the parabola of a quadratic function, the parabola represented by the function f of x is equal to ax squared plus bx plus c will have vertex negative b over 2a, yan po yung h natin, comma, 4ac minus b squared all over 4a. Yan naman po yung k po natin. Since we often find the y coordinate of the vertex by substituting the x coordinate of the vertex into f of x, the vertex may also be designated as negative b over 2a, comma, function of negative b over 2a. How to find the axis of symmetry? So graphs of quadratic equations have symmetry about line through the vertex. This line is called the axis of symmetry. Yun po yung gitna. For a quadratic function of a form f of x is equal to ax squared plus bx plus c, the equation of the axis of symmetry of the parabola is x is equal to negative b over 2a. So, kapag po halimbawa po nasa form na ganito, nasa general form na to, so makukuha natin yung equation of the axis of symmetry by using this formula. So, you're going to find the values of a, b, and c, then substitute to this formula. So, this axis of symmetry is written as x is equal to h. So, papalitan nyo lang kung ano po yung h na yon. Axis of symmetry and vertex of the parabola. Let us have an example po. So, paano naman po the graph of any function of the form f of x is equal to a times the square of x minus h plus k. Nasa form na vertex form. So, will be the parabola with axis of symmetry x is equal to h and vertex at h is equal to k. So, kunin po natin, halimbawa, yung equation of axis of symmetry at saka yung vertex. Let us have this example. So, example po natin, ito po, f of x or y is equal to 2 times the square of x minus 5 plus 7. So, makikita po natin na ang atin pong h natin is positive 5. Ito po yun. So, wag po nating titingnan ito dahil ito po ay operation. So, kung ano po ang sign po nito. So, we have x is equal to 5 is our axis of symmetry. Next, the vertex is h, k. So, ang h natin, ito po yung 5. Then, k natin, ito po yung constant natin, which is 7. So, sa parabola naman po, kung paano malaman kung opens upward or downward, tingnan natin si A. Kapag ang A ay positive, it opens upward. Kasi po, A is greater than 0. So, 2 is greater than 0. So, the parabola opens upward. In this case naman po, sa pangalawang example, f of x or y is equal to negative 1 half times the square of x minus 6 minus 3. So, in this case naman po, so our equation of axis of symmetry is x is equal to 6 or positive 6. So, laging tandaan po, kapag minus yan, positive po ang axis of symmetry natin. Kapag plus yan, negative naman po dito. Lagi pong tandaan. So, the vertex is, copy lang po si h, which is 6. Ito po yun. Then, our k is negative 3 or the constant. Then, the parabola opens downward. Why? Because a is less than 0. Kasi po negative yan. So, lagi pong tatandaan sa opening of the parabola, gaya po na example ko last slide, the sign of A, yung sign ng A, yun po yung numerical coefficient ng quadratic term natin, yun po yung numerical coefficient ng x squared, determines whether the parabola opens upward or downward. So, siya yung nagsasabi kung opens upward ba or opens downward. So, if A is positive, kapag ang A ay positive, laging tatandaan nyo, the parabola opens upward. Again, if A is positive, the parabola opens upward. If A is negative, the parabola opens downward. Again, if A is negative, the parabola opens downward. How to find the x-intercept of the quadratic function? So, to find the x-intercept of a quadratic function, let y is equal to 0 and solve for x. Always remember po, para makuha natin si x-intercept or si x, papalitan natin si y ng 0 o yung f of x natin ng 0. So, this equation, so magiging equation na siya, may be solved by, again, yung mga nakaraang topic natin na pinag-aralan, by factoring, by using quadratic formula, or by completing the square. Most common ang ginagamit natin ay by factoring. Dahil po, dun tayo nadadalian, merong iba na gumagamit ng quadratic formula. At medyo madalang ang gumagamit ng by completing the square. So, how to find the y-intercept of quadratic function? So, kabaliktaran na naman po ng x-intercept. So, ang pagkuha ng y-intercept naman po is let x is equal to 0 and solve for y. So, papalitan lamang po natin lahat ng x ng 0 para ma-solve natin si y. So, how to find the domain of quadratic function? Napakasimple po. Ito ang pinakamadali sa pinakamadali. So, always remember po na ang domain ng quadratic function, lahat po ng quadratic function ay set of all real numbers or set of real numbers. Again, ang domain po ng lahat ng quadratic function is the set of all real numbers or set of real numbers. Yan lagi ang isasagot. So, how to find the range of quadratic function? So, the value of A determine the range of quadratic function. So, sa A tayo magpo-focus. So, parang katulad din po dun sa opening of the parabola. So, dun lang tayo magpo-focus sa A. So, if A is greater than 0, meaning ang A ay positive, the the range of the quadratic function is y such that y is greater than or equal to k. So, papalitan nyo lamang po si k. Ito pa rin po yung format. K lang yung papalitan nyo. So, if a naman is less than 0, meaning ang a ay negative, lahat ay negative, halimbawa yung a, then the range of the quadratic function is y such that y is less than or equal to k. So, again, ito pa rin yung format. Papalitan nyo lamang po si k. So, let us have an illustrative example para malaman nyo po. So, consider the quadratic function y is equal to negative x squared plus 8x minus 12. A, determine whether the parabola opens upward or downward. B, find the vertex. C, find the y-intercept. D, find the x-intercept. E, find the equation of the axis of symmetry. F, find the domain. G, find the range. And H, draw the graph. So, let's determine the parabola opens upward or downward. So, always remember po, yung A natin is negative. Diba po? So, ibig sabihin po, since A is negative 1, which is less than 0, so the parabola opens downward. Lagi po tatandaan yan, ha? So, sabi naman, how to find the vertex? So, dun po sa quadratic function ng given natin kanina, kung babalikan nyo po, kukunin natin ang values ng A, which is negative 1, yung B, which is 8, and C, which is negative 12. Then, let's find H and K. So, yung H natin po, yun po yung may formula po tayo. So, H is equal to negative B over 2A. Then, by using substitution, papalitan nyo po si B ng 8. Papalitan nyo po si A ng negative 1. So, this will become, yan po. Then, you're going to simplify. Very good. So, that is positive 4. Now, let's find k. So, the formula for k is 4ac minus b squared all over 4a. Then again, by substitution, papalitan nyo lamang po si a, si c, si b, at si a nito pong mga values na nandito. Then, substitution. So, 4 times ang a, pinalitan natin ng negative 1. Ang C, pinalta natin ng negative 2. Ang B, pinalta natin ng 8. Then, 4 all over 4 times negative 1. Yun po yung A natin. Then, we're going to simplify. So, 4 times negative 1 times negative 12 is 48. Minus 8 squared is 64. Then, 4 times negative 1 is negative 4. Then, to simplify, that is 4. So, mayroon pa pong other way on how to find k. So, yun nga po. Since the x-coordinate of the vertex is not a fraction, pwede natin pong i-substitute yung x o yung h natin, which is 4, to the original function to determine the y-coordinate of the vertex. So, ang gagawin po natin, so ito po yung given natin kanina, papalitan lang natin lahat ng x ng 4. Then, we're going to simplify. Ang sagot is 4. So, therefore, the vertex h, k is 4, 4. So, ito po yung sagot ng vertex natin. Next, letter C. To find the y-intercept, set x is equal to 0 and solve for y. So, papalitan lamang po natin yung x ng 0. Lahat ng x ng 0. So, para makuha natin si y. So, yan po yung kanina. Then, we simplify. So y-intercept is 0,12. So laging nasa form ng ordered pair po ang y-intercept. So to find the x-intercept naman po, set y is equal to 0. So papalitan lamang po natin doon sa example natin po, yung sa sample quadratic function, ang y ng 0. So pinalitan po natin ang y ng 0, so maging equation siya. We're going to use by factoring. So pinactor natin po ito. So that is x minus 6 and x minus 2 is equal to 0. Then by using zero product property, paghiwalayin po natin, equal natin sa 0 bawat isang factor. Then we use addition property of equality para po makuha natin po ito. So ngayon po, dahil nakuha na po natin yan, dalawa po ang atin pong x-intercept. The first one is 2,0. The other one is 6,0. So laging tandaan, ang x-intercept ay laging nasa ordered pair na form. So paano naman po kukunin ang axis of symmetry? So kung babalikan natin yung letter B natin, so nakuha na kaagad natin yung H, which is 4. So para isulat po siya, dahil equation po ang hinahanap, equation of axis of symmetry, that is X is equal to 4. So papalitan lang lagi natin yung H, di ba? Sabi ko kanina, ang equation of axis of symmetry is X is equal to H. So papalitan lang natin si H ng 4. So the equation of axis of symmetry is x is equal to 4. So how to find the domain of quadratic function? So lagi kong sinasabi sa inyo, ang domain ng lahat ng quadratic function is set of all real numbers. Ito lang lagi ang isasagot sa domain. Then, paano naman po sa range? Dahil ang A is less than 0, so gagamitin natin yung form na y such that y is less than or equal to 4. So kailangan po meron po din po siyang close dito. So ito yung formula natin. Then, for the graph, paano naman po kaya ang graph natin? So ipapakita ko lamang po sa inyo. So yan po yung graph po ng ating quadratic function. Ito po yung ating vertex. Ito po, itong point na to. Ito naman po itong patayong linyang kulay pula. Yan naman po yung tinatawag nating axis of symmetry, which is x is equal to 4. So ito naman po yung ating y-intercept. So dito po siya nagtagpo sa y. Ito po. Then, ito naman po yung mga x-intercept natin. Tumagpo sa x-axis. So that's it everyone. God bless and have a nice day.